welcome. Thanks for showing the interest. May I ask why you specifically chose during this day for this session? What the expectations are up front to see if I... Because we were discussing internally, to be honest, so of what the people of the OpenStack Day, if they would join us in a business update from Lenovo, from the Lenovo side. So I'm very curious what your arguments are to just pick during the day this this session.
Yeah. I can tell you short on the short way. I'm from UWV, public.
Service provider.
Service provider.
Yeah.
And we're approaching to a new data center.
So okay.
That's the interest for us.
Great, great. Then for us, I think it's already a good reason to have this presentation, and I will explain in the story. Any other reasons? I see some old colleagues, which is always good and very nice to see, to share knowledge and the interest of where we are. No? Okay. Then I will start. As said, it's called a little bit of looking back and to the future, and why we decided to look back a little bit. Lenovo, we are now part of Lenovo, and a lot of people, I will tell a little bit later on, a lot of people here in the room, like some of my colleagues, we were part of the acquisition 2.5 years ago of the Systemix Intel server division from IBM to Lenovo. So with that, in the market, there are still some noise that people think that Lenovo took over IBM or IBM even took over Lenovo. No, that's not true. It's just a part of the hardware organization that is taken over by Lenovo and added to their portfolio. We as Lenovo had firstly the workplaces, laptops, things like that. And to be able to deliver a complete portfolio, the data center solutions were acquired. Large company in the world, a global 500 player. Maybe you didn't know that, but it's a. And here is what I mentioned where it all started. And a lot of our former colleagues know, in 1981, IBM already invented the personal computer, and a company called Legend started in 1984 in a real small garage somewhere in China, where the first fundaments were made for Lenovo as you know it. You see several things happening during the timeline. Maybe you might recognize this name, the well-known PCs from the Aldi.
Yeah.
it's part of Lenovo now. It's still an own company. And the home branded PCs of MediaMarkt are also created by Medium, just so you know. And as said, in a period in time in 2014, Lenovo took over from IBM. And I must say, in this period, in 2005, it became, like you see here in LA, is called from Legend. And from Greek, it comes Novo, the new Legend. Therefore stands the name of Lenovo. And we were entered and acquired together with Motorola. So we also are branding now the Motorola phones, as you know it. And with this, the timeline started to be the data center group company within Lenovo. And it's not only that the people are taking over, it was a complete takeover of the research lab, of production labs, of, like I said, the salespeople, the technical people, of course. Where some changes were made. Sometimes people ask, well, do you have a kind of head office or things like that? Well, we don't officially, but you can say that in Beijing we have our traditional head office. And in Raleigh, where the base of IBM Intel service was, is a kind of headquarter from the data center perspective. Like 6,000 people worldwide, large sales population. And based on the past, also a lot of experience in the data center. So a lot of people think, okay, Lenovo service, quite new, not a real big experience. But what you see here is all these kinds of things were developed during our period within IBM. All the techniques are behind it. These were the systems and that we had in that time within Lenovo, but it was quite an OEM from IBM. So the base is already there for a longer period. And what we recently did is we made the world a little bit simpler. We brought everything to the think system line of where you have the traditional servers, where you have some storage solutions, where you have the networking. And our platform from Think Agile is the platform where we will work more with software-defined solutions, so pre-integrated systems, and then you can think of solutions around Microsoft Azure Stack, for example. We have an OEM relation with Nutanix on hyperconverged. So all these solutions are branded within the Think Agile portfolio. So we made the world a little bit simpler with just removing all the names and all the things and all the synonyms we had into two really new branded lines. As said, I won't go through all, but this is here you can see where we have already a kind of background in technology development during the years, and to the fact where we are now. And why I'm just telling this here in this audience, because I found this picture, and like I said, we had some discussions. Where do we make related to the OpenStack subject of today? Well, this was my trigger. It's running on standard hardware, and we were with the Lenovo organization where we are. We want to be the best and to want to be good in delivering standard hardware. And as said, and I see it already on the some reactions of the audience, it's a well-kept secret at this moment in time that we are doing that. So this is my link to where we are today. What are we doing on this a little bit more detailed on the portfolio? As said, we have in the Think System line, we have traditional servers like normal rack servers. We have the Flex to Blade solutions, but also more mission critical solutions for large database applications, and where we are quite a great player already in the high performance computing space. On real, where the density of the systems is important, and there we have some worldwide quite some good successes and reference cases also on that level. I will come back to more details on the pros. And as said in the Think Agile line, we have some more things like the software defined solutions and hyperconverged solutions. so this is really the field where we play and where we want to play. Any questions so far on this, or specific, or is this what was your view on the Lenovo entering the room and now after only seeing this?
I didn't know they had, but of course we saw it on the invitation.
Yes.
I wasn't aware that they had the data center solutions.
Okay.
I only know the brand from laptops.
Yeah. Okay, well, that's good to know. So that, yeah, this is it, what we already do. So added to the portfolio. As I said, what do we have in the portfolio? We have, of course, our rack solutions. We have, with the rebranding of the name of the systems, we also designed the systems completely, and that was because of Intel launched new processors, and it won't be a big surprise that we always follow Intel on the things that are happening. And so they were completely redesigned and rebranded. We have the SRT Blade, the Mission Critical, and the Rack Optimized solutions. But we also have some storage solutions still in our portfolio. We work closely still with IBM on some of these spaces, especially in this area. But also we developed some of our own solutions, also around the software defined solutions. And we have also some networking solutions in the portfolio. And this is also both storage and networking are some good best kept secrets, so that's the reason why we mentioned them as well.
Cisco?
Well, maybe is it competitive on not
combined? Yes.
Yeah.
We are specialized in top rack technology, so east-west traffic. And the more let's say the core switches is a joint venture with Juniper. We have a complete portfolio.
So this, but we want to offer, we want to be able to offer a complete solution within the data center. So therefore, we have, we already had it, but now it's in the portfolio, still in the portfolio. But with the, this is the fact that we want to be good and we want to be grow in the hardware won't say that we don't do other things. The vision of Lenovo and especially for the data center group is that you must combine forces. You can try to do everything yourself. You see acquisitions going on in the market. Okay, Lenovo did it with us. But also hardware software companies going going together, and we have more the vision of being good in providing the hardware that is needed to run the software and the specific solutions on, and find your combinations with partners and with all the solutions you see here, and make it like we say it a meet in the channel, a meet in the market, where you combine all resources and provide solutions to the end customers. We do it on these kind of solutions that and market trends that you see all the names you you might know, but it's also on different levels. We have it of course with Red Hat and SUSE who are here, still with IBM like we said on the storage, but also with DataCore, Nexenta, Cloudian on specific solutions around storage, Nutanix around Hyper-V, SAP around HANA. So a set, and all this hardware is tuned and made ready to run the solution on perfectly. So this is our base and our core, but it won't say that we are not building this this landscape around it. Any questions on this, or any surprises on this, or what you see, or what you didn't may not expect? No? I'll skip this this one. Well, the goal that we want to reach when we when we entered Lenovo 2.5 years ago, the company was calling. We want to be number one within several years. Well, we brought it back to be in the top three. So that's but I think that's still a good ambition to be. We're very proud that we are a leader in customer satisfaction. So this is where we want to stay and we want to grow. And as said, we have a large potential in the supercomputing market. As said, we have some concrete wins already. And there, we have the ambition already to be number one in 2020. And as said, with the goal of being the most trusted data center provider in the world. As said, working with partners, working around solutions. So we have a vision on things like the cloud and the open cloud. But as said, it's for us absolutely a meet in the channel and working with partners that are here, partners and companies you maybe already work with to work on these kind of solutions. Where we are here. For us, this is the key and the strategic play at the moment where we want to be and where we want to be good in. But we absolutely want and need to grow in this area as well. But as said, this is more where we want to do this with partners and solutions, as you can see there. So create the base and grow up to in the whole chain further on.
In your vision, do you see any spots for white boxes from your end of view? In the US, offering the hardware, mm-hmm. offering the software for white boxes?
Not as far as it could be, but it's not that we have anything concrete yet that I can and say, okay, it's there. But being the traditional player and or the good player in the it could be that it might come. But for the moment, we don't have it yet.
We're open for discussion. If you have a customer that's big enough, then we have possibilities.
So this is just a summary on what we see on the future of the data center, where we want to be the player. I think I stayed in my time of half an hour, but to be honest, this was just the message that we want to give in this meeting, that we are there, that we have the kind of solution. If you have more any specific questions, some of our colleagues are also on the booth, so maybe we can help you with things you don't want to discuss here. But any questions around this, or is it clear? Did you miss anything? Or I don't think I blow my old IBM colleagues away, but we know each other very well. So this is where we are as Lenovo Data Center at the moment, roughly.
Thank you.
Yes? Okay. Clear. Thanks for your interest, and I wish you further a good session and day today. Thanks.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Thank you.